Everyone, this is Dr. Sheena Bansal. So today we will do the basics of hepatoplasty. See, firstly, in the preoperative template, you will see the interischial line. In the interischial line, you will see interischial line is a line connecting the ischial tuberosities of both sides. Then you will mark the interteardrop line. Then you will mark the interestabular edge line. Both you will connect the both estabular edge and draw a line. If there is equal difference in between the interestabular and interteardrop line, that means there is no problem at the estabular side. And likewise, you will see the difference between interteardrop line and interischial line at right or left side. If it is equal, then it means there is no problem at the femoral side. Okay, then there is coxa vara and coxa valga. Now you know what is coxa vara. Coxa vara is less than 120 degree angle. Now in the coxa vara, what happens? GT becomes proximal, goes to the proximal side, and there is less lever arm increased, so less joint reaction force is there, but resting length of abductors is increased. So here is the problem. Even joint reaction force is decreasing, but resting length of the abductor muscles is increasing. In the coxa valga, lever arm decreased, joint reaction force is increased. Now there is offset. What is the offset? There is offset, horizontal offset and vertical offset. Horizontal offset is distance between GT to center of head. Vertical offset is center of head to the lesser trochanter. Now we will do the hip biomechanics. See what happens. There is abductor force. Abductor force, there is abductor lever arm. What is abductor lever arm? From the center of head to the abductors. Now there is body weight into body lever arm. So you have to decrease the body weight and you have to medialize the femoral head. Why? Because you want to increase the lever arm. Like you have to, there is abductor force into abductor lever arm is equal to body weight into body lever arm. So you want to decrease the abductor force. Abductor force is equal to body weight into body lever arm and divided by abductor lever arm. So abductor lever arm should be more, body weight should be less. Abductor lever arm will be more if you medialize the head. Body lever arm, okay, so to decrease the abductor force, you have to decrease the body weight and increase the abductor lever arm. Next is, why do we hold cane in opposite hand? To increase the abductor lever arm. Before operating, always get the internal rotation view of the hip to get the true values of. So now we will discuss the use of constraint liners. Constraint liners are used in the abductor muscle injuries and neuromuscular injuries. Contraindicated in the malposition. So now what is a stress shielding? Stress shielding occurs due to the rigid stem. Because now stem is bearing weight. So as we know, according to Wolff's law, osteopenia occurs around the stem. Okay, so pain will be at distal thigh. Pain due to acetabular component occurs at the groin area. There are two types of stems, porous and hydroxyapatite. If you are using hydroxyapatite covering, on growth occurs, and in the porous stems, ingrowth occurs. Keep cement restrictor at 13 cm, acetabular rimming 2 cm more than the cup size is done. In the hip, if there is external rotation deformity present, then you can use the then use the anterolateral approach. If internal rotation deformity is present, then posterior approach is used. In the ankylosing spondylitis, intubation is difficult, spinal anesthesia is difficult, and there is already increased antiversion. So if you keep more antiversion or more antiversion, then there will be more chances of dislocation. So in these patients of ankylosing spondylitis, decrease antiversion because there is already increased antiversion and there is in external rotation deformity. So use the anterolateral approach. Use of cages. Now, if more than 70% of acetabulary cup is covered, then no need of bone graft and cages. If more than 50% head is uncovered, then use graft, cage, and fix it with the screw. Major indication of cages is medial wall defect. In cases of protrusio acetabuli, floor of acetabulum is more medial. Chanlis gave the classification for it. If 1 to 5 centimeter medial, if 5 to 10, then type 2. If more than 50, type 15, type 3. 5 in the type 2 and type 3, you can use graft, and the type 1, you can use cement. Dysplastic, in the dysplastic hip, there is already increased antiversion. It has been classified into three types. In the type 1, dysplasia is there. In the type 2, pseudoacetabulum near the true acetabulum. And in the type 3, far away pseudoacetabulum from the true acetabulum. So you can use here graft, and then you can use the then you can also keep acetabular cup far away. Now approaches are for the hip arthroplasty, anterior, anterolateral, and posterior. In the anterior, the incision, the intersection is done between the tensor fasciae lata and sartorius. In the anterolateral, incision is in line with the shaft of femur to GT to ASIS. In the posterior approach, shaft of femur to GT to PSIS. Ranavat line is lying between the inferior medial calcar region to greater trochanter. Now, acetabular screws are put in the posterior superior quadrant because in the anterior superior there is external iliac artery, in the anterior inferior there is obturator artery, and in the posterior inferior there is sciatic nerve. Intraoperative hip stability can be checked by Schuck test and coplanar test. Cups are of two types, closed and open. Closed means if inclination is less than 40 degree. Open means if inclination is more than 40 degree. Dislocation is further of four types. First is due to acetabular cups more than 40 degree inclination has high chances of dislocation. Stem placement, abductor insufficiency is type 3, impingement is type 4. If you try to crack the more than 4 cm limb length discrepancy, then sciatic nerve is at risk cause of stretch injury. In the DDH, you should not crack more than 2.5 cm, and in the normal people, more than 4 cm should not be corrected. So this was all about basics of arthroplasty, preoperative templating, and intraoperative.